Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. This is Aisha Nazir. The topic of today's lecture is registers. What is registers? Why we need register? How the registers help in fast processing? Let's understand it. So, registers. Register is basically an electronic component, an electronic chip that stores information in form of bits, that is 0 or 1. Register is a small, a very tiny built-in memory on processor that holds instructions, memory addresses and data. It's temporary but very fast memory storage area. Why? Because it's built-in on processor. So as there is less distance, it's near to the processor, so that's why it performs speedy processing. It helps the processor to execute the instructions faster. Registers make the processor faster. Register uses the cells, that's just like boxes, to store bit, that is called flip-flop. Register made up of multiple cells that contains bit. In each cell there is a bit. So the collection of cells are known as register. So there are number of built-in registers in processor that makes the processing speed faster. So different types of registers are: the first one is memory buffer registers. The second one is memory address registers. Third one is instruction register, and then program counter. After that there is accumulator, data register, address register, temporary register, input register and output registers. Let's examine all these registers one by one and see what the part they play in processing of instructions for processor. Usually, registers are of 8 bit, 16 bits and 32 bits. But commonly, 60 bit registers are used in latest processors. Let's understand registers with their sizes with an example. As we have discussed in the previous lectures of cache memory, we understand the concept of memory in detail. So now we will take the same example like the previous one. So the RAM size, that is the primary memory size, is 4096 words. This is the RAM. We split the RAM in equal size blocks and each block size is 16 bit. Means in each block there would be a word which size would be 16 bit. So what is word? As we have discussed earlier, that word is basically a memory representational unit as the byte. To explain the memory, we usually use the term word instead of using the bytes. So the word size is 16 bits, means 2 bytes. So in each block of RAM, it saves 16 bit of word. So the address of the RAM would be 12 bits, as 2 raised to the power 12 is 4096 words. So these are the memory addresses, and as we all know that memory addresses starts from 0, 1, 2 and onwards. So the first would be the 000, then 0001 and then 0002 and onward till the 1111. So the first register is called address register. Address register is very important register. CPU needs read and write data on memory. This is the main task of CPU, that it reads the instructions and it writes data on memory. This register is used to store memory addresses of the data that it reads from the memory and the data that it writes on the memory. It stores the memory addresses of that data. So what it basically did, it picks data from memory like addresses. Addresses stores in address registers. So the AR, that's the address registers, gives the address to memory. Memory decode the addresses and then fetch the data from RAM. So its size would be 12 bits because 2 raised to power 12, as we have discussed earlier. Second one is the memory buffer registers. It stores data coming from memory and the data that is going to the memory. It stores all the information about such data. Next is data register stores the data. Word size in RAM is 16 bits, as we know that. So this is the data. This is the all the elements which we stores in blocks of RAM. This is the data. The block size is 16. So the data register size would be 16 bits. It starts from 0 to 15. After that, the next one is accumulator. Accumulator, it stores intermediate results from ALU to RAM and temporary information of operands. It is also called processor register because all the processing, to perform all the processing, it needs the accumulator. That's why it's known as processor registers. It fetches data from memory and wants to give ALU. So temporarily it holds that data before giving to the ALU. So the size of accumulator would be 16 bits. That starts from the 0 to 15 as the RAM data size is, because it holds data, it's related to data. So its size would be same as the frame size in RAM, 16 bits. So data register and accumulator are of same type and it stores same 16 bit data that start from 0 to 15. After that, the most important register is instruction register. Instruction registers is basically used to store instructions that needs to be executed. As we have discussed the instruction framework in the previous lecture, so let's again recap it. So the instruction basically consists of three parts. The first part is known as I. I is basically the most significant bit. I is most significant bit. It's of either 0 or 1. If 0, it means that it's a direct address. And if it's 1, then it shows that indirect addressings. What means by direct address and indirect address? Basically, direct address means if value, if I, which is the most significant bit, its value is 0, then directly go on that location and fetch data and gives to accumulator. It means it directly goes on that location. But if value is 1, it means it's indirect addressing. First you have to go first location, which points to second location. Then you will go to the second location, which points to third location. And when you will go to the third location, and here you will find the data and you will fetch the data and gives to the accumulator. So I, which is the most significant bit, it's either can be 0 or either can be 1. The next block of instruction is basically opcode. Opcode means the operational code, means the operation to be performed, like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, right? So opcode is basically the operation that we have to perform. The third part of an instruction are basically consist of operands. Operands are those on which the operation has to perform. So the data on which operation has to perform is called operands. Operands has address of data on which we have to perform operation. So instructions would be of 16 bit. The one instruction would be of 16 bits. Operands will be of 12 bits. because it's the memory addresses, and we know that the memory in this scenario, in this example, we know that the usually addresses are of 0 to 11, means 12 bits. Address consists of 12 bits. After that, the opcode has the 3 bits. And after that, the remaining 1 bit is it's for the I, that is the most significant bit. So in short, the instruction would be of 16 bit. So instruction register are basically used to store instructions that needs to be executed. After that, program counter store address of next instruction that is placed in memory. It points only that location where instruction exists. If location is empty, if there is no any instruction, it will never point to it. So it shows only those memory locations where the instruction exists. So its size would be, as we have discussed earlier, it stores the addresses. So its size would be 12 bits. That starts from 0 to 11. After that, temporary registers. Temporary register stores data temporarily. Its size would be 16 bits. After that, the input register. Input registers receives data from input devices like mouse, keyboard, and many more, etc. And provides that data to accumulator and ALU. Its size is 8 bit. It never links to memory at all. It has its own size. It has no any linkage with the memory. So its size is 8 bits. After that, the output registers. Output registers basically receives data from ALU after processing and gives this data, this output to output devices like printer and scanners and many more. So this is all about the registers and the main types of registers. So hopefully you grab the concept. Thank you very much.